One of the viewers on the channel suggested that I make a video on how to bake a texture onto a transparent image, which would mean that the parts which don't have a texture on it will just be transparent. If you want to follow along with this tutorial, feel free to download the free blend file in the description below so you can follow along. You can see to start I've got my object here, which if I press tab to go into edit mode, you can see it's already been marked with seams and then UV unwrapped. If you're new to UV unwrapping and you want to unwrap your own object, I do have a large playlist of UV unwrapping videos which should be able to get you started with knowing how to UV unwrap in Blender. Press tab to come back into object mode, and I'm going to come up to the top left hand corner where a little cross shape will appear, and I'm just going to left click and drag to pull out another menu. The reason I've done this is so I can have a look at my texture while it's being baked. I'm going to change my editor type to UV editor, and if I press tab again in edit mode and press A to select everything, you can see our UV here, which is what our texture is going to be baked onto. Press tab to come back into object mode, and now I'm going to left click and drag this here to pull this up. Right now you can see I'm in this menu here, which is called the shader editor, and you can just find it by left clicking this button here, which might be the timeline by default, and you can just change it to shader editor, and here you should have the material you've made which you want to bake. I'm just using this basic wood material, which we've actually made in a previous tutorial if you want to learn how to make it. When baking any texture, we need something to bake onto, so we're going to need to create a fresh image texture, which is going to be a PNG or a JPEG file, which we can save our texture as. So I'll press Shift A, and then under texture, I'm just going to choose image texture. Then I'm going to left click the plus new, and I'm going to call it base color. I'm going to keep my width and height at 1K, which is 1024px by 1024 pixels. And in order to get the transparent background, first of all, we need to make sure this alpha box is checked. And then secondly, we need to left click this color box. And here you can see there's a parameter called alpha. And we just need to set that value to 0. Then once we've done that, we can just left click new image. And we're going to keep the color space as sRGB, since, as you might know if you've followed along with my free texture baking course here on YouTube, base color textures are for this input on the shader here. Use the sRGB color space. Then the last thing we need to do in our shader editor here is we need to left click our base color so Blender knows to bake it onto this specific image. Then I'm going to come up to my render properties here, and where it says render engine, I'm going to make sure I'm in cycles. Then under sampling, you'll see we have viewport and render, and the one we're looking for here is render. Here I can just set my max samples to something low like 10. If you're baking ambient occlusion, maybe a higher sample count of 100 or 200 would do, but since it's only base color, a low sample count of something like 10 for baking is usually sufficient. Then I could come all the way down to the bake settings. This may be close for you, so I'll just left click to open it, and I'm going to change the bake type from the default, which is combined, to diffuse. Diffuse is just another word for base color. Then under influence, we have the contributions. Direct and indirect refer to the lights which you have in your scene. So since we just want the raw color of our material, I'm just going to turn these two off. Under output, I'm going to want to make sure that under margin, that I've got a margin of around 16 pixels. And that just makes sure there's a margin being created around our UV islands to stop us from having any gaps in our texture. Now I've got all my settings set up, all I need to do is left click this bake button. And if you'll notice here that in our UV editor, a new texture has appeared and something has been baked on here. You'll notice though, if I press tab to go into edit mode and then left click this button here to choose a texture, you can see it hasn't baked onto these circles here. And you'll notice if I come down to my material properties menu, you'll notice that's because this object is actually composed of two different materials, one for putting wood in different directions. So all I need to do is left click the second material, which is just called wood border .001, and I'm going to press Shift A again, and then under texture I'm going to choose image texture, and then I can left click this drop down and choose our base color texture. Then all we need to do is bake again onto this texture, but this time we were referencing this second material, which is applied onto these circles here. So I'll scroll down in my render properties menu to bake, and I'm just going to left click, making sure I have my texture selected. And perfect. Now you can see we've got our texture baked onto this UV. You can see we've got a margin as well around the islands, and you can see we have the transparent background which we were wanting. The last thing we need to do is left click this image button, and you'll notice it has a star beside it indicating it needs to be saved. This is because texture bakes will not be saved automatically into the Blender file and need to be saved as a separate image file on your computer. So I'll come down to save as, find the location on my computer, and I'm just going to press save as image if I'm happy with the name here. If you then make any changes to your texture bake, all you would need to do is left click image and choose save, and it will overwrite that file we just saved. And yeah, that pretty much covers it. If you want to learn more about texture baking or you're new to the subject, I do have a free course and some extra videos which I've made on the topic, which you can check out in this playlist here. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.